Good morning, children. Today we are going to see biology. As we already started chapter 2, that is the microorganisms, friend and foe. Let us continue from where we left. Okay, so as the heading of the chapter tells, microorganism is a friend as well as foe. It is both useful as well as harmful to the human beings. We saw what is a microorganism. Microorganisms are very minute structured living organisms which are all invisible to the naked human eye. They can be seen only with the microscope, and they are present everywhere around us, and they may be either unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular means uni means one cell. Multicellular means many cells. Multi means many cellular cells. Organism. So first, what is a cell? You would have learnt in your lower grades itself. A cell is a basic structural unit that is going to be the building block for all the living organisms, right? Then we discussed that microorganisms are of 5 groups: bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa, and virus. And we also studied about branches of science. Okay, microbiology is a branch of science which deals about microorganisms or microbes. We are going to study about the microbes, means then the study gets the name as microbiology. It is again classified into 5 as bacteriology, virology, protozoology, phycology, and mycology. Bacteriology means, as the name tells, it is a study of bacteria. Virology, study of viruses. Protozoology, study of protozoans. Phycology, study of algae. Mycology, study of fungi. Then we saw a very important fact about viruses. They are all non-living. Yes, so since they are non-living, they do not have any cellular structure. They don't have any cells. But they act as a living organism when they are present inside a host. Okay, so normal cold is caused by a virus. That virus, when it is present in the atmosphere, it is a non-living thing because it does not have any cellular structure. Once it enters the human body, we are the hosts. We are giving a place for the virus to live. So it behaves as a living organism, and it starts to reproduce in the sense it starts to multiply. Okay, then I told you that the microbes may be either unicellular or multicellular. As I told you already, unicellular means uni means one, so single celled microbes. Multicellular means many cells microbes. Here I have listed out certain examples of microorganisms which are unicellular and multicellular. You need to know their names. Though it may be new to you, you would be learning about each and every microorganisms in detail in your upcoming classes. Chlamydomonas is an algae and it is a microorganism. You would learn in detail about how does this Chlamydomonas respond to the atmosphere, how does it move, how does it prepare its food, what is its structure, everything you would be learning. Similar way all the microorganisms do. So what are the unicellular microbes present in plants is bacteria, algae. In algae example, Chlamydomonas and Chlorella are unicellular, and fungi, yeast, is a unicellular microorganism. And when it comes to animals, protozoa, amoeba, euglena, paramecium, all these are protozoa, protozoans. Okay, they are all unicellular microorganisms. It may be asked for your 1 mark. Okay, give examples for protozoa or amoeba as a protozoan or fungi. You must know these examples with their classifications clearly. Next, multicellular microbes. You would have seen here, algae comes here also, but in algae, especially Chlamydomonas and Chlorella are only unicellular, whereas Spirogyra and Nostoc are multicellular microbes of algae. And fungi, bread mold, Aspergillus, Penicillium are multicellular microbes. Penicillium is a microbe and it is a fungi from which penicillin is obtained. Penicillin is an antibiotic which is used to treat many diseases caused in the respiratory tract and all. Okay. This penicillin will treat the diseases caused by the bacteria. It has such a power to treat the disease, but still it is a microbe. Okay, you would learn in this chapter how a microbe is used beneficially to treat disease as well as to create diseases. That is what the heading of the chapter tells, that the microorganism is a friend as well as a enemy. So these microorganisms are present even in dead decaying organic matter. Yes, you could have seen some organic matter put as waste, like the skins and the of the vegetables are peeled off and it is being thrown as a vegetable waste, and it gets rotten and it is being decomposed by the bacteria present, okay, from which the minerals are transferred to the soil. Okay, decomposition. So that is possible only by the presence of microorganisms. Bacteria and fungi live in colonies. As I told you already in the last class, that bacteria will never live alone. It always lives in groups. And it lives, some microbes live as parasites. You first know what is meant by parasite. Parasite means like your viruses, which needs a organism for its survival. It needs a host body for its survival. So microorganisms sometimes may live as parasites also. Example is Plasmodium. Plasmodium is a protozoan and Plasmodium is a pathogen. Okay, the Plasmodium is a protozoan causing disease. Okay, so I give the microorganism a name if it causes a disease. That is called as pathogen. The disease causing microbes are called as pathogens. Okay, Plasmodium is a protozoan and it is a microbe, but still it is causing a disease to the human being. I give another name called pathogens. Clear? Now we are going to see about the types of bacteria. Bacteria is a microorganism and it exists in different shapes and types. Based on the shapes, I classify the bacteria into four different types. The first one is coccus or cocci. The bacteria which are all present in the spherical shape will be called by the name coccus. Coccus is singular, cocci is plural. Okay, so spherical shaped bacteria are given the name coccus. It is again of three types: Diplococcus, Streptococcus, Staphylococcus. See, can you see the coccus, the suffix being added? So it means all these types of bacteria would be spherical in shape. Diplococcus means two spherical shaped bacteria will be attached, two numbers will be present. Okay, two spherical shapes. Streptococcus means a chain formation would be observed. The bacteria would attach like this in the form of a chain. Staphylococcus means a cluster of microorganisms attached together like this. I mean, your bacteria will be attached like this. But all these things are of in the spherical shape. The second type is bacillus. Bacillus type bacteria will appear in rod shape. So this is the rod like structure and this is a bacteria. The bacteria which is present in the form of a rod shape will get the name as bacillus. So based on the structure of the microorganism, I classify them and I give a name. Okay, spirulum. Spirulum means curve shaped, like this curve, some kind of a curve like structure. Vibro. Vibro means comma shaped. Okay, so this is like a very big comma and this is a small. So if the bacteria shapes are in the comma shape, mean then I call them by the name vibro. Okay. And now coming to the nutrition. So the nutrition for the microorganism, though we discussed in the last class, this is a general classification that all the microorganisms may be majority, they are heterotrophic except algae. Because algae are autotrophs. they are heterotrophic either as parasitic or saprophytic. Either they need a host or they live in dead decaying organic matters. Movement. How do the microorganisms move? These microorganisms move by a very important structure called flagella. Flagella is a plural word and its singular word is flagellum. Okay, flagellum is singular, flagella is plural. So all the microorganisms will have a structure called flagella for its movement, to move from one place to another. Apart from the structure, they also move from one place to another via wind, water, and in contact, and when in contact. So if I touch this notebook, if a bacteria is or any microbe is present here, by touching, when the book and my hand is in contact, the microorganism may get transferred to my hand. So they get moved from one place to another either when they are in contact or through wind and water or by having a thin structure called flagellum. So this is amoeba, chlamydomonas, and a bacteria. Okay, as I told you already, chlamydomonas is a, I gave you an example, right? Algae. Chlamydomonas is an example of algae. So amoeba is an example of protozoa. Protozoan, amoeba, chlamydomonas, and bacteria I have drawn here. You could see here the hair like structure coming out of a chlamydomonas. So this hair like structure is called as your flagellum. If there is only one hair, then it is flagellum. Since it is two, it is called by the name flagella. And this is a bacteria, as I told you already. Now it is in the form of a rod shape. So it gets the name as, rod shaped bacteria are called as bacilles. So it is a bacilles and it has so many thin hair like structures around it. So there are so many flagella for its movement. And coming back to your amoeba, this is your amoeba. You would have learnt in your lower grade itself about amoeba. Amoeba is a single cell microorganism, and about its food digestion, how does the food enters through an amoeba and how it is being adjusted out, you would have learned in your lower grades, right? So in this amoeba, it has a false layer, that is a false feet called finger-like projections. Can you see here all these finger-like projections? That is called as pseudopodium. Pseudopodium. The meaning of the word pseudo is always false. Okay, so this is the false feet used for the movement of amoeba. If the amoeba wants to move from one place to another, it moves with the help of pseudopodium. Only the amoeba will have pseudopodia. The remaining microbes will have flagella or wind or water, or in when they are in contact, they move from one place to another. Yes. Next, coming back to the respiration of the microbes. How do the microbes respire? Aerobic or anaerobic? So aerobic means, I hope you know this, you would have learned in your lower grades itself. Aerobic respiration means it needs oxygen to survive. Like us, we all need oxygen for respiration. So we are all aerobic. Anaerobic means anaerobic, the opposite of aerobic. In the absence of oxygen, they live only in the absence of oxygen. So whenever the anaerobic microorganisms come in contact with oxygen or when they are in contact with the air, they die. Okay, this is what the respiration of microorganisms. I have not explained about the reproduction of microorganisms. It would take a lot of time and that is not covered in your syllabus. For until 8th standard, this is more than enough. You would learn in your 9th standard regarding the reproduction of microorganisms. With this, I would like to stop for today's class. And the rest, that is the benefits and the harmfulness of microorganisms, let us see in the tomorrow's class. Thank you, children.